Hello everyone, Ori here. Welcome back to another FIFA tournament video. And today we're gonna have an icon review, and it's gonna be the 86 rated Patrick Kluivert, the Dutch legend. I mean, we all know, how good he was in his days. Four star field move, four star weak foot, high low work rates are just incredible for a striker. He is a right footed player. Bought him for 390. Nationality that he has, increases even more the price, but because you can link him with different players. Of course, an icon doesn't get the links, but of course he can help other players get those hard links. 87 pace, 83 shooting, 77 passing is very, very okay. Dribbling 81 and physical 76. In game, physical looks much better. I don't know why it's just 76, but anyway, man, pace is fantastic. Shooting, it's okay for a striker. Passing, very, very good. Dribbling, now he lacks balance, he lacks agility, his composure not the best, dribbling not the best. That may be a problem. Now I have him on a hunter camp style, but what I would, and all those games, the two games that you're gonna see, guys, are me trying him on a hunter camp style. But maybe an engine will not be bad to him to increase a bit of dribbling, because we're seeing how important is that left stick movement. I mean, so the player can be like even more agile. Outside foot shot and flare are gonna be his traits, and of course a Barcelona legend. He played a lot of games for the Barça team. I'm gonna show you guys how he will play. The formation that I used him, and it's gonna be the 4-2-3-1. He did play as long striker, of course, with the instruction of getting behind and stay forward. And even in a 4-4-2, for me, these are the two like variations that you can play him. 4-4-2, 4-2-3-1, maybe another preferred formation that you guys may have. But of course, he has to be your striker because he's big, tall, he likes to move, he makes the movements. But as a cam or as a midfielder, you just have to play him as a striker up front. Anyway, the games that you guys are going to see now are FUT Champs games. This is the highest of the level that you can really try a card. And you can see here, he started like fantastic for me. Look at that header. That shows you a lot. He's a big boy, just doing damage on my opponent's defense. But 390 for an icon of what Kluivert brings, for me, is just a bit too much. Because FIFA 21, it's about players who can really, move fast with the left analog stick. Patrick Kluivert really suffers in that direction. He's not bad, don't get me wrong. In post-up plays, he can shield the ball very, very well. He wins air duels. He can shoot the ball with his head. Score beautiful headers. But yet again, even the movement are not bad. But yet again, the pace, it's not the worst, but agility is what kills this card, and they may make him a bit of, I don't want to use that card. Agility absolutely kills this card, I would say. Look at here, man. You're an icon, 4-star skill move, 4-star weak foot. You just have to score there. Don't tell me that is my fault, because if I'm not playing Kluivert, I'm reviewing icons, but that Wei Chan of Leipzig from Bundesliga is in my starting 11, and I'm 100% sure that he would have scored that. But anyway, man, that is just not something to really judge a card, but in general, I personally did not like this card. 390 is just way too much for me. Maybe I told you before, nationality does increase his price, but not the worst, not the best. just a normal icon card for me, but me personally, I will not spend all that much. Maximum that I will spend for a card like that at this point of the game, of course, we're talking about at this point of the game, not more than 250. Not more. At 250, that card would be fantastic. I mean, you get an icon, I mean, who is strong, I mean, who really can, I mean, can help you offensively, even that he is like not the fastest or not the most agile player, but in general he not the worst, but just not a player that I would personally use. Another player adopt, let's say like this, for FIFA 21. Here in the second game, he will do a very good game, to be fair to you. But it's not that he didn't perform for my team. It's that in the moment that you touch the player, in the moment that you start playing and start trying him out, you can immediately see that, oh wow, he is not like I was expecting him, because those dribbling attributes, the dribbling stats, really downgrade this card a lot and really make him like not be a proper choice for FIFA 21. But again, man, I mean, I will only use him if you are a fan or you just need a touch icon, absolutely, so that you can link up other players. But to expect that he will win games for you, I'm sorry, man, but you will get, I mean, you will get like not satisfied at the end of a full champion's journey or at the end of a game, because he will let you down a lot. It's not that he does not score, but I mean, he should score more. At least this is how I felt. I tried different icons, for example, like Larsson or Ian Rush, and those are clinical at finishing. At least an icon who doesn't have the best speed or the best dribbling attribute has to be clinical on finishing. That is a beautiful goal there for him. He did equalize the game there. But anyway, man, in general, for me, I will recommend you guys to try out other players or make other choices. Just stay away, at least for the moment, because his price is way too much. I told you, if his price goes to 200, 250, or even less, just buy him. No doubt, he will not be a burden on your team. But again, do not expect him to be the best player on your team, because he just will not be. Here, beautiful build up there, and he will finish beautifully there. I mean, nothing to say there in that highlight. Anyway, man, this is pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. Any recommendations, leave them in comment down below. I will try to review different icons. Again, thank you guys for watching. Bye.